Did actors come into the project and you kind of knew right away whether they were had the derby thing in them or?
I'm pretty sure it's a little bit obvious. I mean, you know, you almost cast yourself. You're sort of a true, you know, self-made badass on your own terms, which is completely representative of the sport. So, I think everyone who was cast definitely brought their own kind of individuality. And I actually think that was a really fun thing that Drew did a great job in the film, is that she created a little family on screen that we haven't seen in a movie together before in a little group. And I think that's like a super delicious moment as a viewer when you're like, oh, I haven't hung out with this exact group of people before. Yeah. It's so fun when there's a certain thing and you see it over and over. You're like, oh, yeah. But when there's something new and it's put together in a different way, it really kind of elevates things.
It's so great, the diversity. Diversity, and especially, I mean, not to segregate it, but just as a female story, just to see real women of different ages and who are all totally unique and have their own idiosyncrasies, and that's really special too. And I think it's a testament to Drew's nature that she likes that kind of individuality.
Well, female energy that's not objectified in a movie is a pretty rare thing. And an entire movie based around that is really a rare thing. So it's kind of exciting.
And it's really indicative of how the sport truly is.
Yeah.
You know, there's a version of this movie that it would have been really slicked up. You would have never seen sweat shine on the girls. You would have seen, you know, nothing but 22-year-olds, you know, size zero girls in every part everywhere. Right. And it just would have, like, lost it. And that she kept the true spirit of how it is, you know, the aesthetic of it in all levels is really, it's a true representation.
So the funny thing is everybody's rough, and at the same time, everybody looks really good.
Yeah.
It's like she went, like, I noticed with almost everybody that it was like, the makeup was perfect. Even it wasn't like overt makeup, but everybody looked great.
But that's the thing of roller derby too, is that the alter ego in the sense of dress up and play. You have that spirit. That's what makes it so unique as well. There's this incredible athleticism mixed with sort of a little bit of the wrestling kind of heightened alter ego vibe.
Yeah, it's like that. It's that swagger, but you know the games are completely real and not choreographed at all. But it does have that special kind of like. All classes, it's kind of, you know, very, has a, like a little really straight working class element, although Derby's got a little more of an underground edge to it. But it might, you know, gain a little more above ground edge now.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll have the little shoppers, what I call like the Barney's girls, what are they going to be?
Yeah. How many Derby costumes for Halloween?
Yeah, that's true.
Will be, then we'll know.
You're going to have Gossip Girl night.
Yeah.
Bring all the girls in there.
Or when Gossip Girl has Derby girls, then we'll know. Like that'll...
It's,
you know,
made
it's
it.
Spread, yeah.
It's in the mainstream.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So what energy does Drew bring to the party? I mean, because I felt like watching the film last night that the film feels like Drew. It has a kind of like very strong positivity about it. With all the stuff that's going on, there's this kind of like very positive energy moving forward that seems to be very much of her.
Mm-hmm.
Is that reasonable? Is that true?
She has an innate like infectious good vibe. And I think even just what I saw a little bit with you guys is just how just cozy and quick the trust seemed with y'all, and just that like she's like a great host throwing the party and everyone's in there right away, you know.
Yeah, and what I love, because I've worked with all kinds of directors and different first-time directors, and I just want to know the person really has their shit together. And so at the end of the day, and I was so knocked out when I first met with her that she had such a strong visual sense, and she knew how she wanted the movie shot. And so that was really encouraging. And then she also, she just sort of was attached to all the characters. And that was really thrilling. So, because I always say a movie set is the vibe of it. It has everything to do with the energy of the director. And she has a real special, but a fierce kind of positivity, you know, it's not lightweight and everybody, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I think there is this thing that sort of like you have this kind of like because she is so warm and, you know, there's warm, cuddly Drew.
Yeah.
But not to be, you know, overlooked is like shrewd, smart, badass businesswoman,
yeah.
get things done, be on it Drew, which is, I think, actually extra impressive and mm-hmm. extra inspiring and empowering when you see her, because it's just like it's no accident, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think there's even that, like that work ethic is represented in the movie as well as the good time. And I think that's, you know, the like to work really hard at something and then enjoy the rewards of it is kind of, you know, that makes it sweet to earn those sweet moments in life, you know, not just have them, you know, handed to you. It's fun.
Is the director the central way you choose to when you're going to come out and play these days as an actress?
Oh yeah, isn't that wild? It had been like 5 years since I did a movie. It's the longest break I've ever taken since I started movies 15 years ago, and it was by choice because I went off to start a whole musical journey as a songwriter and mm-hmm. live performer, and so I had a break. I was done touring. I was on the road with this last record for a year and a half, mm-hmm. and then this opportunity came my way. And it was just the most special thing. And it was like my first part back in movies. And it was sort mm-hmm. of apropos because it's
so
this theme of experience versus youth.
Mm-hmm.
And it's sort of where I am in my life, you know, in my mid-30s. And it was really special. I mean, when I got offered this part, I don't know, I was really, I cried, I'm not gonna lie.
Really?
Yeah. No, just, it was so sweet. I mean, because I wasn't looking, like I went and did something new. That's also the parallel that I really admired about Drew. She's doing something new. Mm-hmm. You'll have some people doubt her, you'll have some people who will support her, and in any case, it's right. something she needs to do, and it's mm-hmm. A calling of hers, and so I related to that as well. But yeah, what brings me to make movies, since it's not my main livelihood, mm-hmm. is really story, character, and filmmaker, always. So, and since then I went on to do a few other movies that mm-hmm. you'll see later, and this is the start of my new 30-something career, I don't know.